tracking anti-government protests in Hong Kong, voicing concern about China's treatment of its Uighur Muslims, looking at the ruling party's domestic and foreign policies, work carried out by human rights groups. Now, a cybersecurity firm claims cyber spies have targeted a number of these NGOs. In a new report, Secureworks alleges the culprits are likely linked to the Chinese state.
Based on the information available to us and looking across a number of different incidents and a campaign that's stretched over a number of years, we're as confident as we can be that China is responsible for this campaign and for those attacks. So we first identified the activity earlier on this year. So we've been looking at it for over 6 months now, but we were able to build back from there and identify activity going back to at least 2014 and possibly earlier.
He described how researchers tracked malware on affected NGO networks and then discovered the alleged theft of data.
These are screenshots that are taken from information we've captured, and they actually show the commands that the attacker was typing in on machines they'd been able to compromise. So we can see them, for example, running a script to collect all PowerPoint files, which we assess they'll then have stolen and moved out of the network.
I've spoken to a human rights group allegedly targeted in what researchers have named the Bronze President cyber campaign. They wanted to remain anonymous. It's perhaps a sign of the fear that these organisations feel about the threat that they and their staff face in cyberspace. This security expert says the cyber threat to NGOs is growing from countries that don't like their work.
Every NGO out there needs to expect that they will be targeted by actors that do not agree with what they do. They are trying to affect social change. They are trying to affect democracy. They are trying to help people who are not in situations to help themselves.
It wasn't immediately possible to get a response from China to the allegations in this report. But whoever was behind the attack, the findings will doubtless put the NGO community on greater cyber alert. Deborah Haynes, Sky News.